You and I, baby. Maybe we can ride away, baby.
How would you know that we existed today if you didn't?
Oh, not us?
Screen time.
Wow.
Trust.
Why does it catch my inhale so
quick?
My voice.
I think I
checked
the
other room.
Yeah.
I've been
wanting to
do that. I'm a
tease friend.
I look cute. Oh, like that.
Yeah.
I'm a boomer. Okay.
It's got feelings, right?
Okay.
Why is it so big, dude?
Coffee. Not chocolate. I see
my chocolate.
What a way.
What are we posting
for? My
fuck.
I thought you were camera shy.
What do you mean? Cameron loves me. I love the camera.
How do I do that?
Get your fingers closer, but put your closer.
It's not moving.
Yeah.
My heart's... Alright, keep walking now. Wait, just eat. Huh?
Oh, wait.
It's a video.
Happy. Oh, so good. The life of a minute.
I know that I don't make me. It's on the first hospo session.
Yeah. Woo! Breach. I fall for you every time I try to resist you. We can get away. Palm trees, beach views, ordinary day. All I wanna hear is in the visions I replay. Sit right next to you. How I feel about you, think you wish you were. But we don't really want to, I just wanna get away and sit right next to you. You, I don't wanna kiss you. Yeah, I just wanna feel you. Feel you. I want you around. Around. I want you around. Around.
Alright, you can either talk about SG today, or you can just smile and wait. Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Ice like the snow and it's gone. Look, you should slide my way. Be easy on the brakes. Black ice never catch me slipping back. I'm about an extraordinary stay in the AO in LA, but that's. chest on Stevie Wonder on replay, replay. We can get away riding down PCA like it's back in the day. Now the record on replay, I'm by your side like Sade. Two lovers in a Bentley, cool. And I try not to show, my eyes can't hide. I'm feeling on a low.
It's 1.5 months since I posted. I'm gonna post my blog, getting it to you.
Okay, here's what we learned in terms of lectures this week. We looked at GIT functions of absorption, digestion. Since we're doing BGDB, we're looking a lot at childhood. So we looked at growth, so factors affecting growth, hormones involved, related to growth, causes of short stature and long stature, and later, Marfan syndrome, endocrine disorders, chromosomal disorders, endocrine disorders, and also bone cartilage disease, emotional and social development in terms of attachment styles, and what happens when a child has not secure attachment to their caregiver, and how that manifests in later life. Also, cognitive development, especially focusing on heart assessment, PRN, assimilation versus accommodation, the four stages of development, so sensory motor, pre-operational, concrete, and then formal logical operation. And related to this, concepts such as magical thinking, egocentrism, object permanence, theory of mind, also looking at causes of delayed cognitive development. Then we looked at normal childhood development, so the domains, and also the milestones within these domains relating to speech, gross motor, fine motor, cognitive, social, stuff. Looking at important milestones such as babbling, brawling, rolling, walking, first words, syllables, stacking blocks, and also red flags. So for example, if they're not like sitting by 8 months, or if they're regressing their milestones, and if they're not doing certain things by a certain age. We had a bit of embryo, so in terms of facial development, structures that develop from the pharyngeal arches 1-4 for the development and parts of the outer, middle, and inner ear, stuff like the external acoustic meatus, the typical membrane, allosynchus, sapies, auditory tubes, cervical canal, cochlear, saccule, utricle. Then the basis of human birth defects, so cleft lip, palate other syndromes, such as Treacher syndrome, fetal alcohol syndrome, DiGeorge, and Pierre Robin syndrome. Then back to GI, we looked at the physiology of GI secretion, so what increases or inhibits this, the digestion of carbs, proteins, and lipids. And then finally, we had microbiome, gun, upper respiratory tract infections, and otitis media other types. So acute chronic E is that otitis media is quite common in kids. The reason behind this being that the eustachian tube is shorter, more horizontal. Yeah, hope that helps.
And on to the next scene. Hello, I'm going to answer some Google Form questions now. So,
do SGs group change? If so, how often do they change? Yes, so you get a new SG every 2 terms. So in phase 1, you'll be in 4 different SGs. Are there lots of opportunities to interact between colleges or not really? I would say it's quite limited. So you're put with other colleges in tutorials and practicals, and for lectures, anyone can come. So you can interact there. However, I think you have to be proactive and go to events like MedCamp, PubCrawl, or academic events, and also stuff like fresher picnics and fresher lunches that MedSoc often organizes at the start of term. With mentors, which year groups do these come from? So mentors are from any year group that are basically not in year 1. So often from year 2 to year 6, but it also depends on who actually signs up to be a mentor. Are they like group mentors or one-on-one? There's actually both. So on your first day, which is the 21st of February this year, you'll be meeting your group mentors, and your mentoring groups will be divided by half of your SG and 4 or 5 mentors. So whilst everyone has a group mentors, I think a one-on-one mentors is opt-in. So someone in MedSoc will send out a form regarding one-on-one mentoring, and you can sign up for that. I would highly recommend you sign up for one-on-one mentoring. It's been really helpful for me. Sorry for asking so many questions. No worries. Feel free to ask whenever and keep them coming. Okay. So someone else asked, is it possible to work during med school during 9 to 5 hours and not the evening? So Monday to Friday, I think it's possible but very difficult because you have to account for travel time, especially if you have in-person classes. Whilst if you had online classes, it'll be easier. Also, practicals and shoots may not be at consistent times every week, so you'll need a very flexible and chill employer who's fine with you rocking on like a week-to-week basis rather than, you know, coming at the same time every week. If you're talking about working on Saturday and Sundays, yeah, it's so chill. So some people work as receptionists, retail, tutoring, and stuff like that. So overall, it is possible but can be very difficult, and make sure you have a very chill employer who's flexible.
Let me drink some water.
Does getting involved with the community, clubs, and societies and volunteering make a difference in getting into medicine when you get to the interview stage? But I suppose it would, because it does give you something to talk about and be passionate about. But don't just do it because you think it'll help you get into med. Do it because you genuinely want to and because you enjoy what you do. Because I'm pretty sure the interviewers will be able to tell if you're doing an activity because you're passionate about it or because you think it'll help you get into med.
Okay, so that's all the questions I had for today. Thanks for watching my vlog. Like, comment, subscribe, turn your notifications on. Take care, stay safe. I will see you in my next video, and bye. Baby, try to get-